Don't be like them, don't be like them, don't be like them, don't be like them. Well, it's a hard, cold, tumbling journey, worthy of a gurney, a bumble down. A slap, grace, smack to the lace, turn to the base, and the tumble down is the path that leads you only one place, horrible to reach, just crumble down. A hard, cold, tumble of a journey, your head down. Extortion fees, money bribes, and such.
Caution.
But
so I thought it would seem no longer alone.
Well, I'll be.
And if I'm not mistaken, that there is his daughter.
So it is. And all grown up, too. Miss Gladwell, a bit late for you to be out and about, don't you think?
Oh, hello, officers.
If I didn't know any better, I'd say you were on a late night behind the bushes to relieve yourself for free kind of walk.
Oh, no, officers, I was coming home from work. First day.
Long hours.
Just like us.
There's some kind of big vote down at the legislature tonight. Plenty of fasting to do.
And copying, I would imagine.
Oh, yes, and copying.
Well, Miss Gladwell, your father mentioned the size and purity of your heart. He neglected, however, to mention the size and purity of your beauty.
Does beauty have a size, officer?
In some countries. I take care on these streets late at night, Miss Gladwell. There's no telling what some people wouldn't do for a few coins.
Oh, I'm not afraid of people, officers.
No?
Not really. Everyone has a heart, you see. As long as you know that you need never fear a soul.
Everyone?
Everyone.
Even criminals?
Even criminals.
Even policemen?
What?
Bobby's wrong.
Out a bit late, don't you think?
Out late taking care of another late night rush is all. There's talk of more fee hikes. People are getting edgy.
Are they? Well, I'm glad to hear you were otherwise engaged. Wouldn't want to put you under suspicion for taking a late night behind the bushes.
I don't need to do that anymore, officers. Not while I work for Miss Pennywise, I don't.
But you still need to keep your head out of the clouds now, don't you?
And what do you mean by that?
What she means is, you're a good boy, Bobby. See to it that you don't end up like your father.
And how did my father end up?
Well, we're off. Our work's never done. Good night.
Good night, officers.
Good night, Bobby.
You were rather brief with them.
I don't care for policemen. Not those two, anyway.
Policemen protect the peace.
Do they?
Usually.
Didn't I see you down by the amenity this morning?
That was me. I was rushing off to work. First day.
Find your way all right?
The gleaming tower on the hill? Couldn't miss it.
Beautiful.
It's rather shiny. That's true enough.
Did you mean what you said to those policemen about everyone having a heart?
Well, sure I did.
Well, because mine feels awful cold just now.
Cold?
Or empty, one of the two.
Not because of me, I hope.
Oh, no. Because of something I did.
Bob, reason with the woman. I'm a little short this morning.
No shorter than yesterday unless I grow.
Or rather, something I didn't do.
Well, if it feels cold, then it must still be there, don't you think?
Unless there's a vacuum where it used to be.
A vacuum? In your chest? It sounds so implausible.
I did something wrong this morning is all I'm trying to say. I can't seem to get it out of my head.
Vacuum?
My action. I let someone down that I love dearly. I feel real bad about it.
Well, maybe that's nature's way of telling you that now's the time to lift someone up.
Really?
Sure. Do you think you'd be feeling as bad as you do if you didn't?
I don't know. I suppose not.
Well, of course you wouldn't. Because then you'd be dead.
When darkness surrounds you and you lose your way, have your own compass that turns night to day, and it's even with you before you depart. Still, even being, it's leading you, follow your heart.
Follow my heart? But to where?
To wherever your heart tells you to go.
Even there?
Even to the clouds. If that's what your heart commands, what's it saying now?
I don't know. I don't know how to listen to my heart.
You have to listen carefully. Here, let me try.
Do you...
Wait a minute! When will I see you again?
afraid in this darkness you can't see me at all. But there's a bright, shining world just waiting to start. I can feel it. Come to amenity number 9 tomorrow. I'll show it to you.
Sure she does, little Sally. He's the hero of the show. She has to love him.
Yeah. Everyone loves Bobby Strong.
Say, you know, Officer Lockstock, what's it like?
What's what like, little Sally?
You're in town.
I can't tell you that, little Sally.
Why not?
Because it's a secret. Its power depends on mystery, that's why. I can't just blurt it out like, there is no You're in Town, we just kill people! No. The information must be oozed out slowly until it bursts forth in one mighty, cathartic moment. Somewhere in Act 2, with everyone singing and things like that.
Oh! I get it.
Well, it's time for the next scene. I really should be going.
At the
event,
when the new
Phoenix
announced, right?
That's the one. So long for now, Sally, and keep your head down.
And so, with this piece of paper, the UGC proudly awards amenity number 9, the first of our new and entirely legal fee hikes, which we hope you all honor and enjoy.
Legal?
What? Of course! No one knows better than the good people at You're in Good Company how difficult times are. But the research into finding the long-term solutions we need is expensive. And so, for the time being, our decision is firm. And we look forward to going to Bria with our new profits. I mean, we look forward to finding lasting solutions. And things like that. Good luck, Miss Pennywise. See you in, well, you know where.
You can't do this to us, Miss Pennywise. It'll be off to your town for the lot of us sooner or later if you do.
It'll be off to your town for me if I don't. Now get in line and have your money ready. New fee hike money, that is.
Miss Pennywise.
Bobby Strong, where the hell have you been?
Sorry I'm late, Miss Pennywise. I was up all night thinking, is all.
Up all night thinking, is it? You work here now, Bobby. You don't need to go in the bushes no more.
But I wasn't...
Like father, like son, that's what I say. Now let's get to work.
But it was about my father that I was thinking, Miss Pennywise. About what happened to him yesterday. About what's happening to all of us.
He broke the law yesterday, Bobby, and that's the end of it.
And what if the law is wrong?
What? Did you say?
I said, what if the law is wrong, Miss Pennywise? What if all this is wrong?
Wrong? You've got a sweet looking head, Bobby, a sweet looking head. But you keep it up there in the clouds day after day after day, and it's gonna come down from there, you hear me? You get that head out of the clouds, Bobby Strong. You get it out of the clouds.
Off in the distance, there's a beautiful horizon.
Right, folks, you know the drill.
Gleaming and radiant, it's what I'll keep my eyes on.
Same as it's always been.
As the world turns to face the sun and start another day, it suddenly occurs to me that maybe we can find another way. Look at the sky, full of hope and promise. It's a shining ideal, how I feel when I look at the sky. Mom!
You take your feet now, Mrs. Strong? Because we're going to feed you, that is.
Daily we make them pay their nickels, dimes, and quarters.
This is all I have, Miss Pennywise.
Daily we break them because we have to follow orders.
Have you enough, Mrs. Strong?
And we keep filling money bags with broken lives and dreams. But what's it for? I can't ignore these black and moral profit-making schemes. Look at the sky, high above this madness. Here below, feel our shame, it must stop in the name of the sky.
This is all I have, Bobby. Is it enough?
You hold on to that money, Mom.
Really?
the fee is the law, Bobby Strong. She'll abide by it or she'll join her husband.
And what if there's a new law in town, Miss Pennywise? A new law that didn't come from any voting process or elected body or process of judicial review, but a brand new law that came from an organ. That's right, a muscular blood pumping organ like this one, right here.
A muscular organ?
Well, can't you see it, Miss Pennywise? This one's too small for you. Why not try this one on for size?
It's blinding me!
Look at the sky. There's a great big heart there. There's a heart in the sky. There just is. Don't ask why. It's the sky.
Don't do this, Bobby. You'll regret it.
Oh, I don't think so. Come on, Ma. This one's in the house. For everyone. Forever.
Yeah!
Sideshow changed their minds soon enough. Just like it changed my mind those many years ago. God, I wish I'd never met you, Caldwell B. Cladwell.
Sorry to interrupt, Daddy. I just wanted to make sure you got your morning glasses.
Why, Hope, you're absolutely glowing.
It would seem that office work agrees with her, what with the copying and all.
And the faxing.
Oh, yes, the faxing. You're a good girl, Hope Cladwell. I used to be one. Before I met your father.
A good girl?
You heard me. 492, 493, just a few more.
Daddy, can I ask you a question?
Sure, Hope, dear. What is it?
Do you believe in love?
Love? Why do you ask?
Just wondering. I met this boy, you see. And
sorry to interrupt, sir. We've got a little problem.
Caldwell!
Long, long time no see.
Ms. Pennywise?
Anyway, sir, it's about public amenity number 9. The people there have rioted.
Rioted?!
They're painful free, Caldwell. I tried to stop them.
The assistant custodian is refusing to take people's money, sir. A young man by the name of Bobby Strong.
Bobby Strong?
They've rescinded the Public Health Act.
And the Water Preservation Act.
Well, can they do that?
It's strictly symbolic, sir. The people gathered there are a very small percentage of the population as a whole.
What's happening, Daddy? I don't understand.
I wouldn't expect a pure and good heart like yours to understand, Hope, dear.
Officer Beryl and I are ready, sir. Just give the word.
What did I tell you, Cladwell? It's a power keg out there, and I have a very important plane to catch. Excuse me.
Tip! You're not going anywhere. Not until we nip this unpleasantness in the bud.
Nip? How so?
You're a Cladwell, Hope, dear. What would you do if the very foundation of your life's work were threatened by the rabble-rousing son of a convicted criminal?
Look deep into his heart, and try to understand what made it pound so angrily.
Angry? Angry, you say? No one gets angry with me. Not without a beating!
Oh, a beating? Daddy, beating people is wrong!
Life is a beating! sooner you understand that, the better.
Then life is wrong.
Embrace it. I have.
Life should be beautiful.
Life is many things. Look closely. You'll see it. I do. I see it everywhere. A little bunny in a meadow is nibbling grass without a care. He's so delightful as he hops for you. You say, hi, bunny, and he stops for you. You pull your trigger, and he drops for you. Goodbye, bunny boo. Hello, rabbit stew. Hit me, boys.
Right behind you, boss.
Don't be the bunny. Don't be the stew. Don't be the dinner. You have better things to do. It ain't no joke. That's why it's funny. So take your cue. Don't be the bunny. Don't be the bunny.
But Daddy, we're talking about people, not animals.
People are animals, Hope dear.
Animals with huge incisors and big floppy feet.
Look closely, you'll see them. I do. I see them everywhere. A little bunny and a tall goose. He needs a measly 50 cents. Our little bunny didn't plan ahead. Poor bunny simply hasn't got the bread. He begs for mercy but gets jailed instead. Tossing feathers in the air as the bunny gets the chair. See the moral people! You're much better than that host. You're born to power. You're in the money. Advice to you.
And read the bunny.
Don't be the bunny.
A little bunny in a toll booth?
You heard me.
But Daddy, bunnies don't drive cars.
Oh, don't they?
No, actually, I don't think they do.
Live long enough, Hope dear. You see many things.
Even a daughter doubting her father?
A little bunny in a shoebox. He thinks he's found a brand new home. So snug and cozy on your closet floor. And then you open up your closet door. Now what's that bunny in my closet for? With a mallet and some clippers, you find out new bunny slippers. Get the message, staff.
You tell them, boss.
Don't be the bunny. Don't be the shoe. Don't get stepped on, oh, the one who steps is you.
You're stepping up to where it's sunny. Step on the floor.
Don't be the bunny. Don't be the bunny. Get yourselves together, people. It's time we bag ourselves a few rabbits. Let's go! Let's go!
One at a time, one at a time. Everyone will get a turn.
Here's some cash, Bobby. Just for you.
I'll keep your cash, friend, and relieve yourself in happiness.
A busy day so far. Busiest on record. If your books are correct. How's the urinal holding up?
Oh, fine. A little spillage. Nothing to be concerned about. The people are happy. That's the main thing.
Police!
Everybody run!
Wait! Hey, you! Wait!
It'll take a lot of explaining to keep us calm, Bobby Strong.
We've taken control of this amenity, officers. The people here pee for free.
That's my amenity, officers. All these people taken away.
Officer, watch that! What is happening?
Why, it's the Act One finale, little Sally. This is where our Cladwell arrives to snuff out the uprising. It's a big song and dance number involving the entire cast.
Snuff out the uprising? But what about Bobby's dreams?
Well, little Sally, dreams only come true in happy musicals. And a few Hollywood movies. And this certainly isn't either of those.
No! Dreams were meant to be crushed! It's nature's way.
Well, this may not be a happy musical, Officer Lockstock, but this is so musical, and when a little girl has been given as many lines as I have, there's still hope for dreams!
Bobby!
Hope?
What are you doing, Bobby? I told you to follow your heart, not season amenity.
I did follow my heart, Hope. Thanks to you.
The amenity won't take much more of this uprising, Caldwell. Bobby's a sweet boy. Not sweet enough to sweet up that spillage, not by a long shot.
The amenity will take as much as it needs to, Miss Pennywise. The days of deprivation are over for these people.
Yeah!
The days of deprivation have just begun. If this madness continues a moment longer.
Sure, Mr. Cladwell. That's what you've been saying for 20 years. And for 20 years, we've waited for the long-term solutions that never came. Well, we're done waiting, you see. For a new day has dawned today. A day of hope and happiness.